because I missed the flight. So maybe you reform me.
Alright, yes.
Alright, look, I listened with keen interest to your presentation, Mr. Atrianos. Thank you. I always love the depth that you bring to it. I recall that this is a battle of fourth interface on this same issue, on how can we really start making some movement, any kind of movement. You talk about 1%, you talk about National Health Act. There's a lot of demand on that side of the table on legislators. But you know, there are baby steps, and I have said it in Accra. We have not done anything, dog. We are talking and talking and talking, like it's talk show. We organize a lot of these conferences. And I'm telling you, at the end of the day, you may be disappointed. And the fault will not be on this side of the table. Because you are making demands, and not some of the ideas, particularly a shadow budget of 2018. Those kind of things start early, like something like what you said. But sir, what are those things that we have done from April, May till today, apart from this call? Apart from this conference that we come to, what are the specifics? What committees have we set up? Which technical committees, which sessions have we had? What are the deliverables? Everything is hanging in the air. You probably go away thinking that maybe as legislators we go away and we meet and take a decision. I can tell you, sir, except maybe there have been meetings that I've not been part of, I don't think that's what's happening. So you will probably get something like, if you're expecting X, you will get Y, and it will be like winking in the dark. I really think that the way you have produced this document, look at this very good document. It says frivolous, what is that document? Or frivolous things that are in the budget. You can also do some of our budget implementation. When we come here, you can say in 2016, we had $131 million shortfall for Gavi. There was this that was brought in. I'm just reading the document now to see that you are carrying over some money for procurement of vaccines. Why did we not spend that money? Why are we carrying it over? Is it that we don't have the gaps? It doesn't make sense. I don't understand it. I think, sir, that as much as you're doing a lot of work on this side, the devil is in the detail. People will do what you expect and not what you expect. We have been doing a lot of inspection by way of oversight. But for budget performance, we need to set up technical committees that will give us results. For this 1%, the National Health Act, there is some responsibility of CSOs. If you want to take the government to court, then you need to make noise. I'm just telling you for the first time that you probably can take legal action to compel the government to maybe activate the Abuja Declaration and things like that. I really think that if we rise from this two-day session, we need to have deliverables, even for 2017. It's not late. They have done a lot of defense, but there's some agencies that have not even come to defend. I like the fact that you said you are going to be having an advocacy with the Speaker and the Senate President. Make that a big deal.
Is your committee or is this
No, but the CSO is driving it.
No, yeah, but it's run by this one.
But on health.
Yes, the revitalization support.
So we need to have a position. Because I tell you, that kind of meeting can come out with the 59 million we're looking for. If we determine that this is what we're going to rise from and make it clear that there will be consequences, legal consequences and all of that, we will begin to get results. Let's not sound the way we are sounding. Dr. Ida, you are sounding too light. If we have said we are going to declare a state of emergency in this sector, then we need to become radicalized. Thank you.